just got news a couple of weeks ago, and we were excited to come over here and announce that we had been approved by HUD to build a apartment complex here in Chipley. It'll be 15 units, financed by HUD, and a little over $1.4 million in cost. I'm going to tell you a little bit about them, but let me introduce a few people. First, Donna Warlick is head of our housing department. This is the 12th time she's done this, so we couldn't do it without her. There was a lot of paperwork to do. There's a lot of competition for units. Probably for the entire state of Florida, this go around, there were less than 30 units awarded, or something like that. We got 15 out of here in Chipley. That's not easy when you're competing with Miami and St. Pete, Orlando, we've been successful every time we've asked HUD for units because they've come to rely on us to run the units properly and build them correctly and to do the job right. We've done an excellent job, and that reputation goes a long way when we're competing to get a few units. And Erskine Wesson's in charge of our retail. Brooke over here is in charge of today. She's our public relations vice president. We have a couple of board members with us, Gary Gliss and Calvin Melton. Appreciate y'all coming. Randy Jones, executive vice president. So thank you, Goodwill people, for being here, and thank the rest of you for joining us today so we could tell you about the exciting news. The biggest thing about what we're doing is that there are 14 families that live here that are probably in less than acceptable conditions. Primarily the ability to be independent. And that's what these apartments offer individuals. 10 of them, I think, Donna, are two bedrooms or one bedroom. What's it? 10 twos, four ones, plus a manager's apartment. So families or individuals can now move out of maybe living with their parents or wherever they're forced to live because of accessibility and live on their own. That's what, because we provide not only the housing that's successful, but financial help to pay for the rent. But all the apartments have low thresholds, everything's one level, doors are wide enough, hallways are wide enough, light switches are at a level where wheelchair-bound people have access to them. Things that we take for granted, like where the controls to the stove. You say on the back of the stove, if you're in a wheelchair, that's an impossible reach, or dangerous reach, maybe. So they're on the front. Refrigerators and freezers are side by side. There's a switch in every apartment. They can notify the manager if there are problems. So these places are safe, and the people are secure where they live. There are roll-in showers, so if someone in a wheelchair can roll right into the shower. Cabinets are lower. The sinks have an opening underneath so you can roll up the wash dishes. So those little things that we take for granted are so important to the independence of people who have trouble with mobility. And those are the first priorities for people. We're excited about offering this opportunity to residents in Chipley. We've had a long-standing relationship with the community here. This store, which used to be across the street, moved it over here. It's been a great success for us. And put a career training center here. And it's done gangbusters as far as helping people secure jobs and educate people in computer science. Do resumes or whatever, but it's been very successful, and we're glad to add this housing feature to to our involvement, our relationship with Chipley. Ben, you want to take it over and talk about your community?
Yes, sir.
Okay.
Thank you very much. We appreciate this opportunity. As you know, this used to be the Chuck Wagon, and as you mentioned, it later became the Goodwill that it is. And really, it has served a better purpose than perhaps what it was formerly, because so many needy people come in here, and like you said, the Career Training Center is probably one of the biggest assets that you brought to this community. As we all know, in today's times, if you don't have computer skills, if you don't have that kind of training, you're not going to get jobs. And so that dedication of Goodwill and providing this kind of skills to our citizens is a very good thing. Donna, I think you called me about a year and a half ago when we started looking for some land over here. And as you know and I know, we looked at a lot of different places, but we're glad that we're able to find something. And you have done a tremendous job to bring these apartments to us. And so thank you very much. And Washington County is very proud of its alliance with Goodwill, and we continue to move up to this continue. Thank you very much.
Washington Square, Nintendo's right there, and right between the shopping center and the Nintendo Credit Union is a drive that goes back to some woods, and so right in that area is where we're going to build them. It's close proximity to the things people need, you know, shopping and medical care and that sort of thing, but it's going to be a nice quiet area for people to live.
It's a lot of, when you look at something like this, the Goodwill, as Donna will tell you, you have to have a lot of components, otherwise you won't get the grant. You've got to have the access to the medical, you've got to have access to shopping, it's got to be on city water, it's got to be on city sewage, a lot of criteria. And when we started looking, we didn't find too many pieces, but we kept at it. Yes.
We found what we really think is perfect. We do have to get it rezoned, so we're
Here's our county.
Todd, you can help
us
with that.
Yeah, we hope that'll work out in our favor, and we think it will. We've been talking about this for a long time. State government changed a little bit, so I hope that we won't have any problems. We would like to start construction this summer. That's a little ambitious. It's usually taking longer than that, but we're going to make every effort to get started this summer. It'll take us 9 to 10 months. We'll bid it out to a number of contractors that we have experience with, and we'll ask those contractors to hire as many people from Washington County as they possibly can, which is to their advantage also.
A win-win.
Thank you all for coming.